Freedom! Go ahead.
I'm Shakes, and on this episode of Calls Would Work, we're going to be removing this transmission and replacing with a remand one on this 2016 four-wheel drive 1500 Silverado. Let's go.
I dropped it, but didn't drop it. All right, take them off for me. I busted them loose.
Grab that drive shaft and slick her on out of there. Huh, I thought it was gonna leak fluid. We'll have to check the level. Huh? I like to wrap up in my drive shafts so they don't get dirt and grit in them. Makes it easier to put them back in. But I wanted to show you guys. So there's some baling wire under here. Not sure what for. But it was under there for sure. All right, let's get this exhaust off of here. We need the big impact and a 13.
Something like this. Get it.
screwing the clamp. We just got a vice grip it to screw it back down because it's spinning in that top. If they'd have made that work with one piece, it wouldn't be so bad. That's a really good exhaust flange, though. I really like that. It's almost like a header flange. Got to unplug the T case and split it. Get her unplugged. There's that one. That one. There's two. Okay, I'll live with that. What kind of fresh new hell is this? Pry bar? All right, now we need, I think, a 15 wrench. Well then. So this is a Jasper Reman transmission. And this bolt nut is loose. This nut is loose. I didn't even need a wrench on that one. The other ones were tight though. They just missed the one. Done too many of these newer ones, and a bunch of the like 99 to 07 stuff. Usually right now I got fluid leaking out of the transmission. Wait on Shakes to get back to help lower that dude down. In the meantime, we will move our efforts up here. Oh, it's broken. We didn't break it. You saw that. It just was just barely on there. Lead off. Jeez. Gosh, I can take you anywhere. Jack.
Wow, you're sleeping fast.
Alright, so it's going to be a race against Jack. Put that there-ish. Alright, now you come over here.
Grab that.
We're coming down, so. Up in here into the nasty. Gives new meaning to doing the nasty. We need the 14 on the long extension for the 3H drive. Orange gun. Yeah. Zoom, zoom, zoom.
Very, very in. tires now.
Try this again. Oh.
Wow.
Huh?
Wow. So back in the day when you talked to girls, did you ask them for their email?
No, we didn't have that back then. You asked them for their phone number, and then you called them and you had to speak to their parents first. Because their parents always answered the phone.
Yeah.
So you had to be like, hey, is so-and-so there? And then you get the, who's this? You know. So, because parents were a lot more involved back then with their kids.
Let's get this out of here. We need a 10 on the gun and a...
bump you around here.
Alright.
So this thing here is a main plug. And you gotta twist it. Don't worry. That a little finesse goes a long way.
So let's deal with this thing. It's like on the starter, but not on the starter. Thank you. hose and then barely move it. Right there, hold it right there. Come here, hold on to this right there. Gotta go a little more that way. Just a little. Oh, there's like one little sweet spot in this thing. So we've got the transmission stab back in. And you probably can't see no much of nothing in there.
Well, no. Kind of light. Let's see here.
All right, there we go. So it's a mess, it's in there. It's bolted up. Now we've got to put the transfer case on. Nope, first we're gonna slide the exhaust in. And then we'll put the transfer case on. Cause that exhaust is a bear. Beep, 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 beep.
Fluid. You can't say tranny anymore. It's gender neutral shift juice. She quiet though. Yep. We don't know. But we do know that it's working good. I drove it in here, so we just gotta wait for it to warm up, check the fluid one more time, and we're done. See ya.